Dear friends, welcome to my video. In this video, I'll show you how you can create a simple video editor app in MATLAB using app designer. So let's start. If you see on my folder, I have already downloaded two sample videos which I'll be using to edit and show the demo of my app. So we'll create a app designer for that. So first I'll quickly create a blank app. And then I'll save it with some name, probably my video editor app. So I'll try to keep it simple and not I won't make it complex, but I just want to show you the concept here. So for video visualization, we'll use this axis over here. So that's why I placed this axis. And then probably I'll need some buttons. So one button I'll need is for play. And so before I get into more details, first let me prepare the axis. So axis, I will make it a little bigger so that it covers most of the part of my app screen. And I won't need all this X, Y and title, so I'll just remove it from here. So title removed, and now I'll remove X and then Y. And once you have removed all these things, if you see all the axes are gone. No, still this X and Y, the labels are there, so we can just quickly remove this X label and then respective Y label. Even we don't need the ticks, so I'll just remove the ticks on X and Y. So basically I'm trying to create it like a box where we can visualize it. So if you see, now most of the things are gone. The only thing which is left is it still looks like an axis. So for that, what we can do is if we quickly select here and go down here, there will be something called box styling. And this box styling, just check this box. So it will become like a box. So now this is our axis which has become like a box or a screen where we will visualize our video. Okay. Now this button will be play button. Probably I can just quickly name it also play button here. If you notice, the name has changed here. And for play button, for the input file name, we need a kind of edit field where the user of your app can enter the file name to which the video to be played. So I can just name it as file name, and that's it. So this, yeah. So apart from this, what more we need is probably I will put some slider will be used to check the time. So I will have to push this a bit down, both of these, and slider I will put from starting from here till the end. So this will show my elapsed time of the video. We'll see how we'll do the programming of that. And again over here for the limit, I think I'll put this from 0 to 1, and major ticks probably is I'll just keep it I think I'll just put 0, 0.5, 1. Yeah. And minor ticks probably I don't need. I'll try to keep it simple. So minor ticks gone, and major ticks label is also 0, 0.5, and 1, and that looks good. Yeah. So to start with, this is my slider which will show me the time of the video, the file name, player. So this is simple. Now, as this is the video editor app, so you can edit certain videos. So two things or two facilities I'll show in this particular tutorial. One is how you can trim a particular video from middle or somewhere. So for that, what I'll need is one more button which will probably say trim. I'll just put it here and name it as a trim. Yes. And to know from where to where you have to cut the videos, you need fields which is nothing but the time, a start time and end time. So this will probably my start time or the time from where the cut should start. And then again I need one more, control C. And control V, and this will be nothing but end time. So I may have to push a little bit here and there. So feel free to do the interface as per your convenience. I'm just trying to be simple here, and I don't want to, although I'm spending time, but I want to be quick here to and complete my layout as quickly as possible. Okay, so trim is done. Now apart from trim, the other thing which I would like to do is add. So say for example you have two different videos, and if you want to add or concatenate those videos into single video, so how you can do it? So although these options are available in advanced video editor apps, but you can create your own video editor app in MATLAB, and which will do it very very easily and very seamlessly. So for this, what I need is probably two text fields where the file name will be entered. So this will be nothing but file one, and this will be nothing but file two. Yeah, so I think more or less our layout is ready. Of course this doesn't look very beautiful, but this will do the job as of now. You can feel free to rearrange your widgets as per your requirement. Okay, so once done this, I think I can expand this file name a little bit more. Yeah, okay. So now we'll start the programming for this or coding for this. So we'll jump to the code view, or rather than jumping directly to code view, what we can also do is we can just add the callbacks. So for play button, we'll first add the callbacks. So in play button callback, what we need is we need to retrieve the file name from this field and then play it. So to retrieve the file name, we need to use nothing but this particular field, which is nothing but this field. So this is corresponding to app.filename.edit field. If you click here, if you notice in this app layout preview, this will get highlighted. So basically we need to retrieve so you have to click here, and then we have to retrieve that. So that is nothing but file name edit field, this one dot, and we have to take the value of it. Okay, so now once we have taken the value, we have to assign this value to a variable, and then we have to pass on this value variable to play our or to play the video or to run this video. So first let's create a new method which will play the video based on the file name whatever we are selecting it to play. So in fact first let's create a property. Is nothing but a variable specific to this class. We can create a private property, and the name of this property we can keep it is file name. Yes, so file name is defined here. So and how we can access it is using app.filename. So this is our one of the local variables, you can say, as specific to this class. So we can just quickly assign this file name, this particular value, app.filename.value over here. So once assigned this, now what we need is we will need a method which will, of course, we'll create a private method because everything will be local to this particular class. And what we can name it is play. So because why it will play the video, we don't need any return output, and app we can use it because it will take a app as an input to this particular method. So if you see, all our methods has this app, so we will pass the data from our local functions to this play function using this app object. So once we have it, so we can call this play, and we can pass app over here as an input argument to this one. And once we have this app play function, so now the main function will start here. So inside the play function, we'll create a video reader. So we'll call our video reader, yes. And in this video reader, we have to give the file name for which we have to read the video. So that will be nothing but this file name what we have created, the app.filename. So there is double dot, I don't know why. Yes, so this video reader will read the content of the file name inside this variable v, and then we can use the frame concept to read the frames one by one and then display that frame on the UI axis what we are creating in the design view over here. Okay, one thing please note, in this app, this, although this is a video editor app, but you will not get the audio of that. It's only I am trying to show how you can play with the frames, because if you want to do both video and audio, you will need computer vision toolbox, and I wanted to show in a very simple way how you can just modify or edit your frame using the MATLAB app designer. Okay, so once done this, so what you can further do is you can probably use this while and has frame and v. So this has frame will keep checking, or it will keep in loop until all the frames of v is considered in this while loop. I'll just put n very quickly. I can also do Control I so that the indentation is done correctly. So once done this, so what we can do is then we can read the frame of the V using the read frame method, and we can call this V inside this here. And once we have frame, then we can use this I am show to show this frame into nothing but we have to also consider our axis, which is nothing but UI axis, app.UI axis, where we want to display. So that's why we will use the parent as the key, and the value will be the UI axis where we want to display our frame one by one. So this will more or less will work as a video player, because whenever we press this method over here, from here it will call it okay, I just pressed Control I to make the indentation correct, and that seems to be fine. So pass error at matrix uses might be invalid. So that error was basic because of one extra end statement, and the moment I deleted it, it is gone. Okay, so now more or less it's done. The player will work perfectly fine, but we need to do certain more things. And basically what we need to do is, if I switch back to my design view, we need to set the slider value, the place where this video is right now. Okay, so for that, what we have to do is we have to get the current time of this frame, and that we can use app dot slider dot value. This should be equal to nothing but my current time of the frame or the video reader wherever this is pointing to. So I can just use v dot current time. Yeah, so this should give me the current time, and the value should set in the slider before in each of this while loop. But what if this current time shoots the or overshoots the time which we have set in our slider? So if you notice, we have set in the slider 0 to 1, and of course upfront we won't know the size of our video. It can be of like 2 seconds, it may be of 20 seconds. So what can we do? So basically what we should do is, before getting into while loop, we can set the slider limit over here. So what we can do is, we can set the slider limits based on the duration of my this video, and that we can get from a method called v.duration. So we will have to set it like a vector 0, v. Yes, so this will give me the duration. So this will set the duration of my slider. But we have to, you can leave it like this, but it will be also good if we can change the level of this slider, which will be nothing but, apart from limit, we have to set the measure ticks and measure ticks level. So for both, what we can do is, we can just quickly add app dot slider dot measure ticks levels. Okay, and this will be nothing but yeah. And please note, measure tick labels are in cell format, so you have to use this curly bracket for that. That's why I'm not using these big brackets. Big brackets are, or square brackets are, for vectors and curly brackets are for cells. So in cells, in that we have to put everything in the string format, because it will just put a label as whatever you enter here in this format. So what we'll use is we'll use the num to string command here to convert our values to string format. And of course the first format first will be 0, because we will always have zero on the start point. The middle point will be nothing but the half of the duration. So we'll just put this v dot duration divided by 2. So control v by 2. Okay, and the third will be nothing but v dot duration, which is nothing but the last value. Okay, so this was about the label. We also have to give the measure ticks. So measure ticks will be, yeah, so if you are getting confused between label and ticks, so I can show you in the design what will the, so this line what you are seeing, a straight lines, that is nothing but ticks, and 0, 0.5, the text is the label. So we have to also ensure that the tick is given. Of course we can ignore and just go ahead with the numbers, that's fine, but it's good to show in this video that you can also give the measure ticks very easily. So I think by mistake I have, yeah, this is 0, then nothing, v duration by 2, and then v duration. This can be in numeric format. Of course it has to be in numeric format, then only it will identify on the scale that what is really happening. Okay, so once we have done it, I think we can go ahead and make trim and add methods as well. But before that, I'll just quickly would like to run this code and see what happens. So this my app comes up, and I would like to run one of these videos and see how it happens. So the name of the video is nothing but sample videos 1.mp4, and I'll just play, and it may take few seconds to start, but I really want to see and ensure that whether it's there's some problem in our code or if it's working. I can switch back to my code view. Everything looks good. So if I go back to my MATLAB environment, okay, so there was some error. It says error using value must be a double scalar within the range of limits. Okay, so there is some error, but if you notice, there is some video which has come up, which is of course of 7.5 seconds long, and it has reached the end, but it is giving some error. So I think what is happening is probably because it's frame, right? So whenever the next frame is coming, it's for some reason it's exceeding the duration. So we can just quickly put a if else check here, and the check will be whether my current time is less than the duration or not. So v dot current less than v dot duration, yes. And of course I'll have to give probably an end again, and then control I to make everything fine. Yeah, so again I'll run quickly, and this time I think I should not get that error again. So I have played again. I'm expecting this time it should take less time, in fact, because it already, if we played this video once, so it should be somewhere in the cache or probably something like that. Let's see. But putting, yeah, so if you notice, it came, but it was very quick, that it quickly completed 7.5 seconds. So probably if it's a longer video, it may take, you may see slowly moving the videos. Of course, it's not so convenient. You have to use your other applications for viewing the video, but yeah, this is one way you can at least visualize what is happening at which frame second. Please note, I'm not putting that facility that wherever you drag it to show you that particular part of the video. As of now, I'll try to keep it simple, and my next focus should be on the probably the trim button, the second button. So let's start. So in the trim, in this, if I come back to my design view, start time and end time, I think I will leave the default values to 0 and 0, and I'll just quickly put a callback function, add button push, yeah, so I'll add a new method here for trim button, and this is the method which I will create here. So in this, what I'll do is I'll first read the video or the file name for which I have to edit. So that is nothing but this is my file name which I'll take from this field. So I can just copy paste the text directly from here, Control C, and I'll just name it again v.filename. Or rather than doing that, I can just directly do a video reader, and in this is the file name. So once we are reading the video directly over here, now to trim, what I have to do is I have to exclude those parts of the frame for which I have entered here in the design view, that please don't exclude the time from this and this from this frame. So in the loop again, I'll run another loop, while loop, and in this loop I will just see whether has frame this particular v, and I'll see whether or exclude this frame and write the remaining frame to probably say another file or another particular file. So I'll create another object or private property here which I'll give name as temp file, because I can name any like temp. Oh, I'll give the name of the temp file. So this is a file which we'll use as an intermediate step to write our trim, whatever we are doing in this trim method, or probably we can use this again in the add method as well to write our video output for the in the temporary version. Okay, so once we have it, once we have that app temp file, we have our temporary file over here. So what we can do is we can just open that file in the write mode. So what we'll do, have to do is video writer, we have to call this, and we have to then call the app.temp file. So and then we have to open this, of course, so we can start writing it. Yes, and before I do anything, I'll just quickly first like to close this as well, because if I don't close, and most of the times then it's a just, and I think I should not have given w in double quotes, because w is already a variable in which contains the file name. So now what I'll do is in this has frame, I can just quickly do a kind of like copy paste or write the, this is a method called write video, which will do nothing but write the frame of this v into my new file. Before I do that, probably I'll have to create frame variable as we did above, read frame, and we have to read the frame from nothing but our video reader, which is v over here. Okay, and but these two lines of code, what it will do is, first it will read the each and every frame from v and write that frame to this w, which is nothing but my temporary file. But to trim the function, we have to ensure that the part which we don't want to include is excluded when we are writing it over here. So for that, we can just quickly have a check over here that v current time should be nothing but, it should be either less than the our start time of the dot value, either it should be less than or it should be greater than the current time should be greater than, it's getting long, so what I'll do is I'll just split it into two lines. So either it should be less or it should be, current time should be greater than app dot end time field dot value. Yeah, So either my current time should be less than the start time or greater than the end time. If these two are true, then and only then do the write operation. Otherwise, just ignore and go to the next level. Yeah. So I think more or less we are done with the trimming. So the only thing which is left is we have to somehow call our play method which we have written above so that it can play my output or whatever the trim file we have created just now. So but after we have done the close, before we call the play method, we have to ensure that the app.file name is updated with my new file name, which is nothing but app.temp file name or temp file. Yeah. And so once we have it, our temp file, then we can call play method with app as an input argument. So I think again more or less it seems to be fine for me. So before I go ahead with the add method, I'll just quickly test our trim functionality. I will first call videos 1.mp4. I'll just play it. I think we have anyway done twice, so should, yeah, if you notice it came very quickly to 7.5 seconds. I'm expecting that video should also come up at, or at least some image, and then we can trim it. Probably we just need we'll trim from 1 second till 6 seconds, so we'll have a video of 2.5 seconds remaining. Yeah, so I'm not sure why it didn't come up, so I'll just play again and see if it in the first shot. Why? I mean, it takes time, I know that it takes time to load the video in the environment, but yeah, okay. So, in the meantime, I'll just start this process. So, I'll trim between 1 and 6 seconds, so I will get a very small video of 2.5 seconds, because 0 to 1 second and 6 seconds to 7.5 seconds, it will be somewhere around 2.5 seconds. So if I start trimming, what it will do is it will first trim, then create a new file called temp file. Yeah, if you notice here, it is already been created, and now it will go to the my play method where it will set all the app slider. So I'm expecting that this should get set by now to 0 to 2.5 seconds, and then yeah, so if you notice it, this is set, and if you notice it's slowly moving now, slowly moving. So yeah, this time, first time we can see it's slowly moving, and we can see how the frames are changing. Okay, so more or less our trim functionality is also working. Now we'll get to the last part of our this code, which is nothing but add button. So I tried to keep simple, but then also if you are noticing the my code is getting long and long, and even this video tutorial is getting pretty long, but I will try to complete it quickly. So this will be a bit long method. So we'll first have we'll need both the text field here. So that is nothing but app dot file one edit field dot value. So, and then I will also create a similarly another one, which is nothing but v2 app file to edit field value. So in this v1 and v2 we have read the file names which is there. So now we can create a video reader out of it. So but before we read the video reader, we have to ensure that file names exist. So we can use quickly check is file, and so whether v1 is file or not, and also we can in this same if assume we can also check whether v2 is also file or not. So we have to proceed only and only if both are true, that even v1 is a file and v2 is also a file. So if any one of these is false, so basically we can put another negate this particular check. So if any one of this is false, so then what we have to do is in that case we have to create a message box, or we can create any kind of error depending upon your choice, and then we can use something like file1 and file2 must be defined, and this will be nothing but the title will be yes, and we have to return because we don't need to proceed once this particular error is fine. That is basically if v1 or v2, any one of this is not a file or is an empty file or not the correct name, then we must not proceed, because otherwise our app will not work and it will probably crash also. Now we can use our video reader again, as we have done for other cases, and we can read quickly. So I'll create both for v1 and v2. So once done this, what else we will need is, we will need probably our the file to which we have to write. So we'll again use the temp file what we have created in our previous trim method. So in this, instead of video reader, we'll call it with video writer, and that will be nothing but the my file name. So that is app dot temp file. Yes. So once we have it, we have to of course open it as we did in our previous case. And now once done, what we have to do is, we have to again do the looping like while as frame v1. So in this case, we'll just keep on writing as I explained in my in the trim function. In that case, we use a if else condition to check, but in this case we will just copy paste, because we are anyway adding one by one each and every frame of v1. We are to nothing but our v, so we'll use something called w4. So here of course instead of frame, yeah, so in this while loop, one by one it will read all the frames of this v1 video and write it to the w. So before we close this w, our temporary file where we are writing, we have to ensure that we also do the same for v2, I mean the second video. So then only it will concatenate one by one. So first it will write v1 and then it will write v2. Now we can easily close our w over here. Yes. So and similarly we'll do the same thing as we did for our trim method above. So we'll call the probably we can copy paste it lines of the code. So we have to ensure that we give the file name our temporary file name, and we then call the play method to play and display our part on this screen. So over here what we'll do is, we'll one by one give both the sample videos 1.mp4, sample videos 2.mp4. If the spelling is wrong or something wrong, or probably we can first try our error message itself. So I'll just, yes, this is what I was expecting. So one of the file name is either wrong or does not exist, it will give file 1 and file 2 this error what we have yeah, must be defined. So it will not let you proceed, and it will be a kind of like safety, it will keep your code or app safe from crashing. So once you have given both the names correctly, of course it will not give any error, and it will keep on processing. So what basically it's trying to do is, over here it's reading first one and the second video, and then one by one is writing to the temp file what we have created over here. I'm expecting the size should significantly get increased here, because we are going to add both these files in this particular video. And so let's see, I could have put a breakpoint to see what is happening actually here, but yeah, so this will take time definitely, because it's a 9 MB and 5 MB file. So and please note that when you use this write video, it will take much more space than what it is by default you get, because it also depends upon the size. One more thing you should note, like when you are concatenating two videos, they should be of the same size, which means the width and the height of the video frame should be same, because if it's not same, it won't be able to write it to the new particular file in which you are trying to concatenate, because it will show a mismatch error. Yeah, so if you notice, it didn't take very long as I expected. So it is done, and it has created around a 112 MB file, the temp file over here. And in this screen, if you notice that it's running, it's almost 22.5 seconds video. So our first video was 7.5 seconds. So definitely the second video is around 15 seconds video. So once this crosses 7.5 seconds, which should be somewhere here, our second video should start. So we'll just keep looking at it, and yeah. So if you notice over here, it switched to some my other video, and which is nothing but a green layout and all those things it's trying to show here. Perfect. So once we have done it, probably I will just show some more things over here. I'll just trim this new file which we have created by adding these two files, sample videos 1 and sample videos 2. So for that I will do one thing, I'll just create another file over here and name it as probably new file. Yes, and then I'll use this new file over here and concatenate or trim it, not concatenate, trim it. So its length is around 22.5 seconds. So I'll trim it again from 1 second till 20 seconds. So then my output file will be of around 3.5 seconds, because 0 to 1 second is 1 second, and then 20 to 22.5 seconds is 2.5 seconds. So balance or the output file I'm expecting is of 3.5 seconds, where the first 1 second will be of the first video and the last 2.5 seconds will be of this video which you are visualizing right now on the screen. So once this is done, I'll probably just quickly click on trim. Yeah, I think the above one is done because it has reached to the end. So now I'll quickly click on trim, and again we have to wait, of course, because it will take some time in the back end to read this particular new file and then trim it. But I'm expecting that this scale will change to my 3.5 seconds. And of course, we can also read the temp file directly and play it. But for trim or add options, we have to ensure that we don't use temp file as an input, because temp file is our output. So if you try to have both the file names same, it may throw an error or exceptions of some kind. Okay, so it's taking a bit longer than what I expected, but let's see if it's doing something. Yeah, so if you notice, it got changed. It's not 3.5 seconds, it's 3.467 seconds. So that means our second video was not of completely 15 seconds, it was a bit less. But nevertheless, it has concatenated, and our new file temp file is of course of much less size, also of only 18 MB, because it's just of 3.5 seconds. Before I end this video, one more last thing I would like to show is, probably we can do a bit more fancy stuff also in this GUI. Just for the sake of timing, I won't show too much of things, but I'll just show that what we can do is, in this slider, we can also add callbacks like value change. Whenever the value change of this slider or something, or probably whenever the value of this particular field changes, then we can have a particular callback where we set the value of our slider accordingly. So whenever this value changes over here, so what we'll have to do is, we are already getting the file name in the local variable called value over here. So then we can have a local variable called for video reader, because we'll have to get the duration of our this video. So we'll have to use the uh, we'll have to use the video reader to read that video thing, and then we can use our this commands what we use above here to set the slider limits and the ticks. So whenever control V, so the advantage of this method will be the moment any new file name you entered here, the duration of this will very quickly change. So we can just quickly visualize how it happens. So although if you notice, and I'll just clear this because this view of from the previous run that those errors. So now over here, if I say for example, if I put new file which is somewhere around 22.5 seconds, so I'm expecting that it will change the scale from 0 to 22.5 seconds. Please ensure that you have so if you notice, the moment I just set the file name, the scale changed. Now if I from new file dot avi, I'll probably change it to temp file dot avi, so it changed to 3.46667 seconds. Similarly, if I change it to sample videos 2.mp4, so it changed to 0 to 15 seconds. So this is something which I wanted to very quickly show, that you can just play with this slider values just by quickly adding a callback for this particular value change of this particular field. Okay, so more or less in this video you would have learned how you can put simple functions, like how you can trim your video, or how you can concatenate two videos into one particular video, how you can play the video, and how you can have a slider where you can see the time of the flow of the video. The only thing which I'm not completing this video is how you can, by scrolling this slider, how you can render a particular video at a particular time over here, and also a pause button. So just to keep this video short, already it has been quite long, but just to keep this video short, I will like to stop here. And I hope you like this video. If you have any questions, please put it in my comment section. And if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. And if you have any questions, or if you want any kind of follow-up videos on this, please put it in my comment section. I will try to give you more clarification. I can't put all the data, all the information in one video, so I have to be very short. So so I will just like to thank my audience to watch this video, and I would like to end it over here. So just before that, I'll just try to summarize this video, or this particular program is pretty simple. You have to just add few callbacks, which is nothing but play button, trim button, and add button, and of course this we added at the end. So these are your methods which will be getting created. A bit long is the add button and the trim button, where you have to consider the, in the trim button you have to consider the start time and end time. In the add button you have to consider both the videos, read them, then get them use the video reader to read the files into a particular local variables, and then you can use the video writer to write those frames into a new file. And the new file we have created using a property called temp file, which is so which is nothing but a local variable for this class, and we have initialized it in the class itself. Okay, so thanks for watching. Probably I'll try to paste this complete code in my description section, so that you can access this particular code. Thanks for watching, and have a nice day. Bye.